Hello everyone, I welcome you all to the Infinity Vision platform. Right now I'll be doing one such question that came in your JEE Main examination. This question came on 31st August 2021 in shift 2. So let us see this question first. Question says, it is a statement based question. So let us see the statement. What are the statement? Choose the incorrect statement. Out of these four statements, you need to find out which statement is correct or incorrect. You need to find out which statement is incorrect. Okay, so let us read out the first statement. It says the electric lines of force entering into a Gaussian surface provides a negative flux. This statement is true because whenever electric flux enters through a given area, okay, the area vector would be pointing in this opposite to the direction of electric field. Okay, so the flux linked through must be equal to E dot ds. Okay, so E dot ds must be equal to negative, so you'll be getting negative flux. Okay, because the flux linked through it is, flux is nothing but E dot ds, where E is an electric field and A is an area vector. Okay, so E dot ds, which is A, E dot A, so E dot A comes out with the dot product of these two, because so it must be equal to EA cos 180 degree, and 180 degree is minus, so it would be must be equal to minus of E into A. The flux linked through it, so then must be equal to negative. Okay, because the area is in the opposite direction as compared to while entering electric field lines. If it is entering, if the electric field lines are entering, the area would be in opposite direction, so that's why you will be getting negative flux. So that means first statement is true. What about second? A charge Q is placed at the center of a cube. So now if charge Q is placed at the center of a cube, so let me redraw the cube first. So this is a charge Q has been placed at the center of a cube. Okay, so the flux through all the faces will be same. Obviously it would be same because it is the center. The total number of magnetic total number of electric flux field lines originating, they must go through all these faces. And how many faces you have? 1 2 3 4 5 6. So you'll be having 6 faces. Okay, and the charge is placed at its middle, so the number of electric field lines crossing any particular area must be same because it is at a equal distance from all these points, and we also know that it is equivalent to Q in by epsilon naught. Okay, so E dot ds or flux must be equal to Q in by epsilon naught, so it would be Q by epsilon naught. This is the total flux coming out from a charge Q. Okay, now it has to go through six same faces, so the flux linked through each faces must be equal to each face must be equal to Q in by 6 epsilon, don't you think? So the flux linked through each faces must be equal. I hope this statement is also true and it is clear to you. So we'll be moving to the C option. In a uniform electric field, net flux through a closed Gaussian surface containing no net charge is zero. Okay, so the uniform electric field, net flux through closed Gaussian surface containing no charge is zero. This statement is also true. Why is it so? If you have been given a closed surface, let it be a cube, and this much of flux, suppose if electric field comes from left and these are uniform electric field, so and no charge has been placed inside this Gaussian surface, so it means, so whatever the flux coming from this end, which is a negative flux, and whatever the flux coming from the other end, which is a positive flux, they're gonna cancel out each other. So that means the area would be, because this area is in this direction, so the you'll be getting negative flux over here, and in this particular point the area would be in this direction. Okay, so here the flux is positive, so the total flux entering into this closed Gaussian surface must be equal to zero, because this total flux must be equal to minus EA plus EA, So it must be equal to 0. Okay, the upper end, the lower end and the side faces won't contribute in flux. Okay, because the area is pointing out to be in perpendicular direction to that of the electric flux. Again, cos 90 is 0. So that's why the upper lower area and the side area won't contribute in the electric flux. Okay, so I hope this thing is clear to everyone. So that means the statement third C is also true. Now we'll be moving to the D statement. As of now, all the three statements are true. So we'll be moving to the D statement. It says when electric field is parallel to the Gaussian surface, it provides a finite non-zero flux. It provides a finite non-zero flux. It says if Gaussian surface, it says if an electric field is parallel to the Gaussian surface. So you have been given this, let this be the Gaussian surface, and again electric field is in this direction only. So if it is parallel, so the area vector, area of this surface must be perpendicular to the electric field. So again in this situation also flux linked must be equal to 0. So but it says it is non-zero flux. You will be getting non-zero flux, which is not possible because you won't be getting any flux linked through this area. So that means only D statement is incorrect, rest other statements are true. Okay, I hope this question is clear to everyone. Thank you.